Praise the Lord, everyone. This is Apostle Chance. Prophet Linda is not here tonight. She has laryngitis. Prophet Melissa is here with us, taking care of all the cameras and stuff. And of course, always Pastor Edward F. Chance is always in the house of God with us as well. We want to welcome you tonight to Echo Ridge, Scottsdale, Arizona. Soaring Eagle Ministries, we always on mountain time. So we want to welcome you tonight, share with others to come on. And as we listen to Kim Walker, what's the name of it?
On My Side.
On My Side. And so let's listen to a few minutes to Kim Walker as we don't own the rights to the music, but let's enjoy it anyway. So welcome everyone as you come on tonight. Share with someone else. Amen. God bless you. Thank you, Lord. Prophet Renee, welcome tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Prophet Wendy tonight.
You are on my side.
Thank you, Jesus. Sister Christina, see you tonight.
You're on my side.
Sister Sharon. Thank you, Lord. Welcome, Sister Beverly, tonight.
You tell my fear to run. Always and forever, I am loved. Oh, you are on my side. You go before me.
Yes, He does.
You stand behind.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
He goes before us, doesn't He? How many people really know that tonight, that God goes before us? Amen. We just want to again welcome everyone tonight. And let's open with prayer. Tonight there's so many sick, so many has COVID. We have so many requests of people that has COVID tonight. Some, even at this very hour, just going to the emergency room. And they put them on ventilators ever what they're doing right now, and so they're asking for prayer as well. And so we want tonight just to know that, let somebody know that God cares. Amen. And I believe that here at Soinigo Ministries, Voice of Truth, that we want to project to people that we care about their lives tonight. So let's just go to the night in prayer for all those tonight that that has COVID, that has some other issues, babies being born and having some issues. And so we just want to ask you tonight that Scott and Stephanie, I think this is Paula's brother's wife who has COVID, Christine on the reservation has COVID, my grandson Kyle, my daughter has COVID, my grandson in Connecticut has COVID, Vanessa and her family has COVID, of course Prophetess has laryngitis tonight, and of course the baby has other issues. And then there is my brother, Pastor Stoney of Lighthouse Tabernacle in Garner, North Carolina, is asking for prayer for a church building for their church is growing after many years of standing with the Lord. Mm-hmm. And there's so many others that I won't even mention tonight, but these are important prayer requests. People are believing God that God will reach down and intervene in their situation. Amen. And you maybe have some tonight. Just type them right there out. Just believe God. And my mother-in-law started antibiotics for headaches and sore throat. Pray for strength and healing. It usually starts that way. And, you know, we're not giving COVID the glory, the devil the glory, but we are saying that God is the victor. The Lord has power tonight. Mm-hmm. And I believe that God is on our side. As a matter of fact, I don't just believe that. I know that. Amen. And we're believing. Yes, we will be together again in a physical setting. But, you know, things have its own timing about things. And so we'll just wait on God's timing. And pray for all the grandchildren. Niece has COVID. I see Sister Beverly's grandkids has and niece has COVID. So it's really rampant. I spoke with Sister Millie, I think Friday or Saturday, she said 200 on the reservation has it, 7 have died from it. And so, saints, take this thing serious. If you don't have the shot, get the shot. You say, well, I've got the Lord. Well, that's fine. I got the Lord too, but I take other provisions. I got the Lord, but I still have to eat. So I go down the store and buy food. And so just be realistic about this thing and take all the precautions that we can to make sure that we come out on the other side. Mm-hmm. Amen. Let's pray for all these needs tonight. Some I'm not even going to try to mention it. We're just going to pray for them. Father God, Lord, we come before you tonight. We come with the body of Christ to pray for these needs, to pray for this virus. Almighty God, we bind it in the name of Jesus Christ. You are the great physician. You are our healer. You are the miracle worker. You're the one who intervenes. We've seen you do signs and wonders and miracles in the past. We will see you do signs and wonders and miracles at this hour and in the times and the futures ahead. But Lord, we believe you on the wings of mercy and grace tonight. Fathers, you've even released the angels for divine protection around your people, Lord. In Jesus' name, we pray tonight and we decree and declare that it is done in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. All right. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Thank the Lord tonight as we come together again and we give God the honor and the praise for that. You know, again, God has graced us to come together. Mm-hmm. Again, to see each other through technology that has been given to us. And so we thank God for that tonight. And the Lord, I didn't know Prophet was not going to be with me tonight, but she woke up this morning feeling not feeling very well. But the Lord, you know, when God spoke physically, and I see you on here tonight, honey, good to see you. But when you see, when you have the Lord to speak a personal word to you, need to take notice. Mm-hmm. I said, you need to take notice. And the Lord spoke to me, and the Lord said these words. The Lord said, I am on your side. Now, I know that God is going to be on all of our sides tonight, but God personally spoke that to me. And he said, I am on your side. Now, I know that. Yes, I know that. It's in the Word of God. Mm-hmm. God fulfills His Word. But Lord wanted me to know, in this hour and in this time, He said, I am on your side. And I thank Him for that. You, mm-hmm. you cannot imagine what that means when God speaks personally to you that way. Amen. Mm-hmm. And I know many of you have had God to speak to you as well. And you've heard His voice. That's God speaking personally to you. Never take that for granted. That is so wonderful tonight. So I first of all, I give the Lord the honor and the privilege, and I thank Him tonight for saying those words to me, because I had no idea that God would speak to me this morning when I woke up. And I try to meditate on Him for a while. And you know, and let me say this to all of you tonight. If you're not waking up in the morning, waking up early enough to meditate on the Lord before you start your day, before you have your coffee, your donuts, or whatever you do, just hold back for just a little bit and rest in the Lord. You say, well, what if God don't speak? Don't worry about that. Mm-hmm. Rest in the Lord, and God will speak to you in His own time. Amen. But just rest in Him. Keep your mind on Him. Meditate on Him. Don't let it float around. Don't let it wander. Just keep your mind on the Lord. Amen. Said, this is your time, Lord, and so I'm giving you the right to my life right now. All right, so that's a good word for all of you tonight. You need to begin to apply that. Amen. I said, you need to begin to apply that. And so, of course, as I said again, the Lord said He's on my side. But you know, I think He's on our side. He's on your side. You can take that word, O-U-R, and put a Y to it. And so God is on your side. Mm-hmm. He's on our side. He's on your side. He's on my side. Amen. He's not a God of any particular person. He's on all of His people's side tonight. Mm-hmm. And so I want to say to you tonight that today, amen, when we hear the Word of God, when we hear the Word of God like this, and I'm conveying what I heard from God, and somebody has to tell you what God said to them, if we're going to hear what God said to the church. That's what it says in the book of Revelation. He that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. So somebody had to speak out that word, what God was saying to the church. So I'm speaking out to you tonight as the church, what God is saying by His Spirit. And the Bible said, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit is saying to the church. Now, I ask you a question tonight. Do you have an ear at this moment and this time, no matter where you're living at? Amen. You're hearing what God is saying. And say, God, this is for me that I need, amen, to know that you're on my side. Now, when we say this, we don't even know what God means a lot about this, because we don't know what we're going to face in life. We don't know what we're going to face in life, but I know this, whatever we may face, God said, I'm going to be on your side. And I tell you what, you can get no better, nothing no better than that for God to be on our side tonight. I want to read you a scripture. Now, we of course, you can go back and you can read Romans, the 8th chapter, that whole chapter, where God says that, that if God is for us, who can be against us? That's in the Word of God. Paul outlines a lot, everything in the 8th chapter, a lot of things in the 8th chapter about God is on our side. God is on our side. God is on our side. Amen. Even if devils and angels come and speak untruth, he says, God is on our side. No matter what happens, just read the 8th chapter, refresh your mind tonight. It talks about God is on our side. If God be for us, who can be us against us? And of course, also here he's talking about as sons of God. And I want to say to you tonight, irregardless of male or female, you are sons of God tonight. Mm-hmm. My wife cooks some spaghetti, and I think, amen, praise the Lord. But did you get what I'm saying tonight? Praise the Lord. Someone said God is just for me. Yes, I think it should be for all of us. It mm-hmm. certainly was for me this morning. Mm-hmm. I took this literally for me. Amen. Now, the Bible says in Psalms 118, verses 6 and 8, amen, the Lord is with me. I will not be afraid of what man can do to me. Now, we've heard this before. The Lord is with me. He is my helper. What? He is my helper. I will look in triumph on my enemies. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than trust in man. Yes, our refuge is in the Lord tonight. Amen. And even if God needs to, he'll send his angels in regards to us tonight. So, and I know that God has dispatched his angels many times to the body of Christ throughout the world to divinely protect them from Satan and his demon powers. Amen. And so, but God is saying to us tonight, we will triumph over our enemies. Amen. Enemies, plural. And so God says we're going to triumph over our enemies. Amen. We triumph him by quoting the word of God. We triumph over him by praying the word of God. We triumph, we stand and rebuke in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. So God is on our side. Amen. No matter how many enemies we pray face tonight, God is on my side. It's like saying, listen, in all of our fight against the enemy tonight, no matter what the enemy is trying to do to us tonight or do against us tonight, we are destined to win by God Almighty himself. Mm-hmm. I want you to, we are destined to win. Some of you, don't listen to the enemy. Don't listen to that other voice. You are destined to win by God Almighty himself. Amen. You cannot lose because God is on your side. Do you believe that? You cannot lose. Now, sometimes it may seem like it. An enemy may try to tell you it is going to happen, but that's a lie from the enemy. It will not happen. God is on our side. Hallelujah. And so, let me tell you one thing to do is all of us need to remain. I said, we need to remain filled with the Lord's Spirit, filled with the Lord. You need to know that you've been filled with the Lord's Spirit every day. Every day, filled with the Lord's Spirit. And listen, and when we're filled with the Lord's Spirit, even though sometimes it seems like we'll fall and we'll face failure, amen, but he's right there. He's right there because we're filled with his Spirit. He picks us up. He helps us. He lets us know he's going to help us go through these things. And so stay filled with God's Spirit. Stay filled with God's Spirit. Now, another thing I found as God released this prophetic word to me is that when we are declaring and predicting the word of God, God said, no matter what is happening in the future, I've already told you. I'm not going to tell you after this happened. I'm going to tell you before it happens. Now, some of you need to grab a hold of that right now because God is going to be telling you things before it happens, not after, or not even when, but he's going to tell you things before they even happen that you will be victorious over them because God said, I am on your side when you get there. Hallelujah. Did you get that? Hallelujah. So stay filled with God's Spirit. Even though we see this virus that is rampant, raging everywhere. And, you know, if you listen to the news, they tell us, you know, everybody's going to get it. Well, I'm refusing. We've been there and done that. We're not going that route anymore. So we're just going to serve the Lord. We're placing our confidence in him, and he's going to keep us in a safe place. God is going to keep us in a safe place. You need to say, God, you're going to keep me in a safe place. You're going to order my steps that I don't walk in any place that this virus is. And if I happen to be there, you are going to protect me from it. Amen. And I know in my own heart that the Lord has had to protect us from the virus when we've gone out from time to time in the last few weeks. Amen. Because people won't wear the mask, you know, and they won't social distance and none of those things. But we do have the Spirit of God that will protect us. Amen. And so, if we continue to confess that the Lord is on our side, know that he's on our side, know that he's ordained his power to keep us, amen, we'll find that God is going to be on our side. You know, I like to often sometimes talk about Joseph just for a short period of time. And the reason I like Joseph so much is because Joseph's life is so much like sometimes human life. And so even though he went maybe to a greater extent than some of us would walk in our lives. But I think Joseph felt sometime that, you know, and Joseph was, of course, a son of Jacob. Amen. Now think about it, a son of Jacob. and he was betrayed, he was relied on, he was abandoned, he was sentenced by the very ones that he blessed, the very ones that he blessed their household, amen, the leadership in that household caused him to be sentenced and put into prison. Isn't that amazing? I'm doing my best, God. I'm serving you. Amen. I know because of me, this household is getting blessed. And yet, because of Satan, because of lies, they turn around, amen, and the enemy tries to take his life, try to take him out and abort his destiny that God has for him. Can somebody say amen this morning? Amen. Or this tonight? It's tonight, not the morning. Okay, I'm not that bad. Amen. So Joseph found out that everyone had, and you think about it, when your families turn on you, and where your work, your workplace, and the wife has lied about you, the boss man's turned on you, amen. And you know, is this thing? It just gets compounded and gets worse. And so when everyone turned against him, his future looked very hopeless. And some of you question your future. You question your future. Listen, that's the thing the enemy wants you to do. He wants you to get you to doubt your, I'm talking to somebody right now. He wants you to doubt your future in the Lord. In the Lord. Not in this world, but in the Lord. I'm going to tell you, if you believe God, your future in the Lord is safe and secure. The thing is, you don't know what you're going to have to walk out in order to walk out to the other side. Mm-hmm. Amen. So Joseph found everyone had turned against him. His future looked hopeless. Now, you put yourself in his place. The man's wife had lied on him. The man had caused him to be put in prison. And he knew he wasn't supposed to be there. He didn't see any way out. He hadn't heard the voice of God. He had not heard the voice of God now. Think about it. When you don't hear the voice of God. Hallelujah. Think about that one thing. He's in prison. He hasn't heard the voice of God now. He knew what had taken place just a few days back, but now he's in prison. Hallelujah. But see, I believe that he's looking for God's plans to work in his life. Whatever those plans may have been, he's looking for God to show up. And I'm going to tell you something else. When you read Joseph, you look for God to show up in your life. With his plans. Mm-hmm. With his plans. See, sometimes you have plans, but your plans blind you to God's plans. Mm-hmm. That's a word for somebody else tonight. I'm telling you what God is saying. You have your plans, but sometimes when God comes along with his plan, you say, wow, this don't look like that'll work. My God, my plans will work, but your plans, right. I don't think that's going to work. Yeah. That's exactly what God's going to use sometimes. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. So, but, you know, God was there to lead him. The Lord was there to restore him. Listen, Job found out in a little while, it wasn't overnight, but he found out in a little while that the Lord was going to restore him mm-hmm. to that place that God had promised him. So the Lord, in this time, God taught him that he could only trust in the Lord. I said, yes, the man did certain things for him, but when the ultimate thing happened, he realized that he could only trust in the Lord. Amen. And so, see, sometime, and I put this down just tonight as I was praying. I put down, God, when God gets you, when God gets you where he wants you to go, to do the work. Let me do this again. When God gets you where he wants you to do a work, the work is first going to be done in you. The work is first going to be done in you. And if there's a work to be done in you, that means you haven't arrived yet. Get that. You haven't arrived yet, but you're on your way. Mm-hmm. Say with me tonight, I'm on my way. I may not have arrived yet, but I'm on my way. Amen. And I gave this to one of my spiritual daughters today. I was walking around in the house, and the Lord spoke to me about her. And the Lord said, send her this word. The Lord says, he is not only the Lord of the valley, but also she's going to experience the God of the mountaintops. Hallelujah. And she said, I needed to hear this today. He's not only the God of the valley. You know, I know when the Bible said he's the lily of the valley. We know that. But he also, he said, I'm the God of the mountaintop. Now, that is also very prophetic. Amen. Now, John 14:6 tells us, Jesus answered, I am the way and the truth. Now, when we're walking with God, God has already told us he's the way, he's the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through him. And so if we're going to walk with Jesus Christ tonight, he's going to be the truth, he's going to be the life, and he's going to be the way. Those things work together. The way, the truth, and the life. Amen. We have to have the life of Jesus. Psalms, I love this, Psalms 1 and 12 and verse 2, his descendants. We are the descendants of the Lord Jesus Christ. His descendants will be mightily on earth. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Did you get that? The generation of the upright will be blessed. Are you upright today? Are you walking in righteousness today? Or do you think you can just do any old thing, any old way, and God will say, that's okay. That's okay. No, God's not going to say that. I heard the Lord say the other morning that God is going to purge people's lives. He's going to purge their lives. He's going to purge some things out of our lives that need to be purged, amen, that we can be blessed even more from the Lord. Not about that. Would you allow God to purge things out of your life that you know that he needs to purge out tonight? Would you allow him to do that? Or would you resist him? Or would you even deny it was even there? Some people deny it's even there. Some of the nine, they don't want God to clean the house. Amen. I'm fine just the way I am. But why is it that God keeps talking to you? Why is it that God keeps coming to you? You know why? Because he sees some things that need to be removed that you can be more fruitful. Amen. I believe in this scripture in our lives, and it's out of the ESV Bible, it's Ephesians 3 and 20. Now to him who is able to do far more abundantly than we all ask or think, according to the power that works in us. And this power that works in us has to do with being purged. Been walking upright with God. Are you listening to me? Been purged. It is imperative that we be purged. As time continues, and time will continue. The Lord continues to talk about time is continuing. The Lord continues. His time is winding up. Time is speeding up. All those things we see coming to pass. Listen, we need to get more serious about this thing. And we're living in a time that the Lord tells us that we will live in before the coming of the Lord. You know, I was just showing my wife the other day. I said, they were showing this little bus on the news the other morning, and they were showing it where you can carry seven medical passengers from one place to the other. And has no driver. It's a bubble. Looks like a bubble. Looks like a two-tier. And I said, this is what was prophesied is going to take place just at the coming of the Lord. And we're seeing more and more of this. I watched the morning, two previous mornings before that, as I saw an 18-wheeler driving down the freeway, I-17 from Phoenix all the way to Flagstaff, turned around from Flagstaff and drove all the way back down. No driver. Now, isn't that spooky? Isn't that crazy? Oh, those things can happen. Oh, no. Increase of knowledge. It is taking place in our day. Things are speeding up. We're seeing things come to pass in our generation that no other generation has ever seen. Mm-hmm. We're seeing it. Where God said, we're going to see it before the coming of the Lord. So I try to be mindful of what the Lord is showing me. I said, I try to be mindful of what the Lord is showing me. Yes, that is right. Increase of technology. Amazing thing. Growing up as a boy, I would have never dreamed that I would see such things as I see today in the earth. Amen. But you know, regardless of what I ever thought, this is restoration. This is God moving forward. God's trying to move his church forward into what he's doing in this season and this time. And so we need to keep our minds alert and keep our focus on Jesus Christ and listening to what he's saying. Amen. We could not be doing this broadcast tonight unless it was by technology. Come on. Many of us would be sitting home tonight in our houses, maybe teaching our families or whatever the case may be, but we wouldn't have the availability of the church coming to us. Amen. Or the message coming to us. But as a body of Christ, we can gather tonight all over the United States of America and all over the world to hear this message and be together as believers in Christ. We may not know each other by name, but we're here in Jesus Christ. Know that we have gathered together tonight because he says, forsake not the assemblies of ourselves together as we see this day coming upon us. What day? Look at it. Look what's going on. What day? The day of the virus. The day of the plagues. But God said, I've made available to my people to still be able to come together. Don't make an excuse. Well, I don't have time. You know, I don't have this. And da, 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 da. God knows when we make excuses tonight. Are you listening to me? God knows every excuse and he knows every lie that we say. Hallelujah. All right, so time is speeding up. And the Lord said this, and I keep coming back to this scripture in Luke 17, chapter 26th verse and 27th verse. Just as it was in the days of Noah. We got to get this. Now we've lived weeks and months and years. We've lived. And we're seeing things come up on the earth that astonishes us. So also will it be in the days of the Son of Man. So will it be in the days of the Son of Man. Days of the Son of Man. People were eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage up to the day that Noah entered the ark. And then the flood came and destroyed them all. They were consumed with the living. They were consumed with the things on the earth and not the things of God. And as God's people, we can be consumed with the things on the earth and not can be consumed with the things of God that he will have us to do tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Not that we don't spread it, not we can't enjoy something on the earth. But let me tell you something. We better make sure that that does not consume all of our time. We better be walking and praying and seeking the Lord and hearing from heaven what he's doing tonight. Amen. And that something else came to me as I was about to put this down. And the Lord said, Lot was captured once. Listen now. Lot was captured once. That did not get his attention. In the place that he was living in Sodom and Gomorrah, he was captured once. That didn't get his attention. He went right back there. Don't you think I would have changed my dwelling place if I saw this taking place? But it didn't. It didn't change him. He went right back to Sodom and Gomorrah. And Abraham, as a result, of course, we know today, is sending the angels, amen, to rescue him and tell him he needs to leave there because God is getting ready to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah. Now, I think the Bible said, as it was in the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, it shall be as it was in Sodom and Gomorrah. Now,
Sodom,
Gomorrah. But this time, Lot escaped with only his clothes on his back and his two daughters. And his wife, of course, turned back and didn't make it. Now, I think that's food for thought there. We better not keep turning a deaf ear for what God is saying to us tonight because, God, we may escape once. What was to make us think we're going to keep on escaping if we'll keep on involving ourselves in things that's not of God. So yes, let us have be on the wings of God's mercy and grace tonight that we have ears to hear what the Spirit is saying. Mm-hmm. Amen. I've always taken the approach that whatever God says, I'm going to try to obey it. Amen. So there is a truth here that God is saying a truth here. The Bible said that we want to need to walk upright with the Lord because Noah was a man that walked upright with God. Isn't that right?
That's right.
A man that walked upright with God. I've said again, Why weren't there any more preachers in Lot's day? If you go back and read the Bible, it was a corrupt and wicked generation. Now, I'm going to tell you, that's sort of frightening. How many preachers will fall by the wayside? How many of God's people will fall by the wayside? Because the Bible warns us in the last days, many will fall by the wayside. Mm-hmm. Listen, are you listening to me? So God continues to warn, he continues to talk. Amen. You cannot afford to look away from the Lord. You must continue to focus on the Lord and his will in your life tonight. So if we, and I believe this, and I believe this as God said, he's on our side. And if we continue to walk upright with God, because you'll see here that Noah was a man that walked upright with God. And God gave him his plan for escape from this earth. Mm-hmm. Do you believe that?
That's right.
I said God gave him his plan to be able to escape the flood that was coming upon the earth. Now, I know there's not another flood coming. We know that. Amen. We see flooding, but not the whole earth. And so, but God said that Moses was a man that walked upright before God in his generation. He found grace with God. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. And so we are going to expect God to give us his plan in this time, in this season. I'm not going to run out and grab some plan of my own that will not work, but I am going to stick with the plan that God gives me. And when God gives me a plan, I know that it will work because God said, I gave you the plan, and it will work. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, we may say, we need to do this. And the problem is when everybody begins to say, you need to do something. Well, no, I need to do what God says.
That's right.
I need to hear God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I need to hear God. Hallelujah. What this man or this woman is doing over here may not be what God wants me to do.
Mm-hmm.
And so I need to hear what the Lord wants me to do.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Somebody say praise the Lord tonight. I can't hear
praise
you.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. So, And so Noah was a man that walked upright before the Lord. Amen. God told him what to do. He told him how to build that ark. He gave him an allotted time to build it. He preached the word of God. And yet he could convince nobody, amen, that this ark would protect them, amen, from the flood that was coming upon the earth.
Mm-hmm.
Only his family, amen, three sons and three daughter-in-laws, but the only ones he could get to believe him, what he was doing was of the Lord. Think about that. Only seven other people would believe him what he was doing was of God. You think about that. Think about that for a moment. Boy, there's a lot of people that was fooled. There was a lot of people that didn't believe what he was doing was of God. But he knew that at the expense and the toil, everything that God gave him and the provisions that God made, he knew it was God.
Mm-hmm.
Because God was speaking. And he moved by, Bible said he moved by fear. But see, the Bible starts off in the book of Hebrews. It says that God warned him. Warned him. Amen. And I believe many people will not even receive the warnings of God in these last days. That's the reason they're going to fall away.
Mm-hmm.
Is because they won't believe the warnings of God. Oh, it's for another time. I haven't got time to do that. I haven't got time to listen to God. Well, you will have time one day, but it may be too late. Amen. So God wants us to walk upright. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Hallelujah. Someone said it rains on the just and the unjust. Amen, it does. That it does. That it does. Thank you, Lord. Now, the Lord personally came down to this earth, to this little round ball spinning around in the universe, come down to see about his inheritance. That's right, his inheritance. He came down to see that man was very wicked, very wicked. Came down to see that man was corrupt and he was corrupt in his ways. And you know, I think God could come down today and say the same thing about our society today all over the world. Very corrupt, very corrupt. Came down to observe. God didn't come down just as a blank, as a flying saucer or something zipping by. The Bible said he came down to observe. He came down to observe. I mean, God doesn't do things half-half. He does it all the way. He came down to observe how humans were living. Came down to observe how they were acting. He saw great violence upon the earth. Saw that man's heart was continually evil. And therefore it forced God to say he was going to have to start all over with 8 people. And he did. Amen. If you force the hand of God, God will still go on. Thank you, Lord. I don't know who that's for tonight, but God said if you force the hand of God, he will go on. Thank you, Lord. But we must walk right in this time of impending danger, judgment to someone upon the earth. Hebrews 11, let me read this to you, 11 and 4. I love this. And what a task that God gave Noah. By faith, Noah, when warned, it wasn't a long, drawn-out thing. The warning took place. God began to tell him, began to give him his plans, began to say, start now, get ready, because this earth is going to flood. Amen. And so, by faith, Noah, when warned about things not yet seen, and there's so many things that we have not seen yet. We have seen much in our lifetime, but I do believe that we haven't seen anything as of yet. And that's the reason we must continue to listen to the voice of God that speaks to us. If nobody hears what God is saying, you hear yourself. You hear yourself. When you tell others and they don't listen, you still believe what God told you. Mm-hmm. And don't keep on laboring about it. Don't worry about it. Mm-hmm. I've learned in my life walking with God when I've warned people and God says, son, that's enough. Keep on going. Go on. Don't warn anymore. I just walk on with God. Mm-hmm. Why did I do that? Because God said, you warned them enough. Keep on walking with me. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord. Now, so, by faith, Noah, when warned about things not seen, in holy fear. If he's ever lived right, he wants to live more right. Mm-hmm. Holy fear. Built an ark to save his family. By his faith, he condemned the world and became heir of the righteous that by faith. Now, your first focus, as we are talking about the harvest is coming up on the earth, you need to start focusing upon your family being saved. Your, first of all, your natural family. Each one of you sharing me tonight, pray for your natural family, and I'm sure you probably have. And don't forget to continue to pray for them. Yes, as we reach out to others, as we talk to others, as we see others saved. But listen, I want to see my natural family saved. Yeah. My children, my grandchildren, great-grandchildren, my son-in-laws and daughter-in-laws and so forth. I want to see my biological family saved on this earth and go to heaven to be with Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. And so I'm sure that many of you probably are, maybe all of you, that's really saved tonight. You feel that way. You want your families to be saved. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, sir. You pray for them. Now, when that flood came, it was proven that the words that God gave Noah was true, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. Isn't that right? Mm-hmm. That God vindicated Noah. He vindicated his word. God vindicated his word that he gave to Noah. That's right. His word that he gave to Noah. Now, if God gives us a word, a true word from God, I don't care who don't believe it or disbelieve it, he will vindicate that word, and people will see he vindicated it. Amen. They'll see that he was right. She was right. They were right. Do you get that? Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. So keep on. Quit trying to prove you're right. Mm-hmm. I'm giving you a word. Quit trying to prove you're right. You're stressing yourself, wearing yourself out, trying to prove to people that you're right. Say what God says and let it be that.
That's right.
Amen. That's right. Say what God says and let it be that. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Did somebody just get a word from God? Thank you, Lord. Someone said, yes, I was Prophet Renee said, yes, I was just reassured when my sister-in-law said she had received Jesus as her Lord. And said, see, there it is. Amen. Mm-hmm. You got to give them over to the Lord. Mm-hmm. You got to give people over to the Lord. We can't save them. Only God can.
That's right.
That's right. But we push them. Amen. We lift them before God that they'll be saved. Our children. That's right. Sister Paula, your children, your grandchildren, amen. Your daughter, whoever, amen, will be saved tonight, amen. Hallelujah.
Stand in the gap.
Standing in the gap, thank you.
That's right. That's right.
Standing in the gap. We stand in the gap for so many tonight, amen. So we want to reach out now to families to be saved. Mm-hmm. And you know, God has a plan that once they get saved, they're going to be planted in the house of the Lord. Did you know that? When they get saved, they're going to be planted in the house of the Lord. I believe that. Amen. Because God tells us his plan is to be planted in the house of the Lord where we will be fruitful and we'll be multiplied. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
And so as we prepare for the harvest tonight, remember to pray for our loved ones. Keep our loved ones before the Lord. Now, remember I said earlier, as I said to one of our spiritual daughters in the Lord, that the Lord said he was God in the valley and he's God in the mountaintop. Now, Noah realized he was God in the valley. Mm-hmm. He realized that he was God when he was making that ark. Amen. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. I don't know how far God is going to take us on that ark, but it's going to be sufficient for God to take us where he's going with it. Isn't it an amazing thing when he started out in the plains, the Bible said. That ark was built in a plain. But God said, I have the power and the ability to take it and rest it in the mountaintops of Ararat. Mm-hmm. And I wrote that down in closing tonight. And in Genesis 8, chapter the 4th and the 5th verse, listen to this, the power of God. Hallelujah, the power of God. And on the 17th day of the 7th month, the ark came to rest on the mountains of Ararat. The waters continued to recede until the 10th month. And on the first day of the 10th month, the tops of the mountains became visible. Hallelujah. Isn't that amazing?
Mm-hmm.
He built that ark in the plains. Praise the Lord. But when it was all finished and said and done and the flood was over, he rested in the tops of Mount Ararat. Hallelujah. I'm going to tell you right now, we may be down here on this earth and we're doing the work of the Lord. But when it's all finished, the Bible said we'll walk the streets of gold. Amen. He says, I've gone ahead of you and I've prepared you a mansion, a place to live in, saith the Lord. Saints, it's going to be worth it all. It's going to be worth it all to realize that God is on our side. And the Bible says that when the angel spoke to the men, amen, before they went back to Jerusalem, this same Jesus whom you've seen shall come back in like fashion to receive you unto himself. Jesus is coming to receive his people one day from this earth, amen. What a glorious and wonderful time is going to be. I'm going to tell you, we're all going to be lifted up together. Come on, somebody. Amen. As Noah and his family was lifted up together to Mount Ararat, except we're going to be lifted up much higher than the mountains. We're going to be lifted up to the place where God reigns, who sits on the throne, and all the earth and all the world and all the demons are going to bow down and cry out to him, holy, 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 holy. What a wonderful time it's going to be, saints. And so let's continue to walk with the Lord. Mm-hmm. And just remember that God is on our side tonight. I know you know that, but I said, but when God says that, amen, it takes a different meaning. Mm-hmm. I'm on your side. And so matter, you heard me tonight. No matter what takes place in your life, no matter, come on, what comes against you, remember, I preached this message to you tonight. God said prophetically, I am on your side.
Amen.
And there's nothing that the enemy can do against you. Hallelujah. And you will reach your destiny in the Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, that's right. You will reach your destiny in the Lord. That's what we have for you tonight. Amen. So I hope that you glean something out of this. This is what the Lord shared with me. That he's on our side. So when you work in the hospital, or you're a security guard, or you a nurse, or you are a receptionist, or wherever you may be, you know, just remember that God is on your side. Amen. You don't go anywhere without taking him with you. Right. Remember also to stay filled with his Spirit. When you go out of the house, when you go to your job, listen to me, when you go to your job, be filled with the Spirit. And because as you're filled with the Spirit, you may be praying for somebody. Not only is it just for your benefit, you may be praying for somebody. Are you listening to me? Hallelujah. And you may be, amen, to give a word, amen, at that hour and that moment, God will give you the boldness. God will give you the boldness. In the hour that you needed to speak what he would have you to speak. Because listen, I don't believe that God is raising his church up just to stand around and be silent. I believe there's going to be key times and key moments and key places that you're going to speak the word of God. You have not planned to do it, the Bible says. But he says, in that hour, that time, I'll give you the words that I will have you to speak. For me, myself, the Almighty God. And it will have impact, and it will be fruitful in the hour that I tell you to speak it, and in the place that I tell you to speak it in, saith the Lord. Saith the Lord. Hallelujah. We need to give God more credit in our lives than we do tonight. Amen. That he is in control of us and not we ourselves. Hallelujah. When we get up in the morning, he bids, Lord, where should I walk? How should I walk? Who should I meet? What should I say? And I'm depending on you to orchestrate my steps. Because the Bible said that our steps are ordered by God Almighty each day. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And God is going to detour us around things that's harmful to us and keep us safe. Hallelujah. Do you believe that tonight? Mm-hmm. I want to tell you, amen, let God stay in control of your life tonight. Mm-hmm. And you will be most blessed. And the people that come around you will be blessed if you let God be in control of your life. Mm-hmm. Don't just walk around as people in confusion. Walk upright, and let people know that you are somebody walking for Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. That's all we have tonight. Prophetess Melissa will be soloing tomorrow. And we were saying to her today, you've come to that place that you can do this yourself. And, you know, that's what it's all about. Multiplication. Mm-hmm. Multiplication. As we move forward, we're not stopping. Amen. We may not be holding in a church building, but we're not stopping. No. We're going forward. Right. I depend on you guys to be praying for us. That's right. Oh, yeah, we're fighting warfare. There's a question about it. I know we're fighting warfare. Mm-hmm. I mean, my wife said, it seems like the more people that call us to prayer, the harder, much greater warfare that comes our way. But we count it all joy. We count it all joy. Amen. To work for the Lord Jesus Christ and stand believing God for great and mighty things tonight. And when we pray, it makes a difference in people's lives. Amen. Because we want to stand in the gap for others. Amen. Thank you, Lord. So we'll see you tomorrow. God bless you as we have a word of prayer in closing. Father, I thank you for those tonight that was on, that you will continue to keep them by your power, that you will continue to lead and guide them, that, Lord, that they'll continue, amen, to ask you for guidance and direction in their lives. Lord, that they will be truthful. They will be truthful to you. They will walk upright before you. Lord, they will honor the words that they will walk, amen, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ tonight. And Father, we ask you to bless them. Keep them as the apple of your eye tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. God bless you. I'll see you by the grace of God Sunday morning. Thank you, Lord.